Feeling like taking a coffee break? So do I. What about we talk about JEP 378 about text blocks? This JEP has been delivered in the JDK 15 in September 2020 as a final and permanent feature. Before we start, I would like to thank you for your comments on the previous videos. I do read your comments, so feel free to ask questions or tell me what you think. And because there are people doubting that I like coffee, I just changed my mug, so yes, there is coffee in my mug, and a good one, at least in French standards. So let us go back to the JEP 378. As it is the case for most of the JEPs, this JEP has been previewed twice in the JDK 13 and 14. Following the feedback, adjustments were made before text blocks became a final and permanent feature. This is quite often the case for the JEPs. In each version of the JDK, some features are published as preview features or incubator features. The goal is to get user feedback and to be able to modify things before they made final and permanent features. Once the final version is published, we know that a feature will not be able to change to preserve backward compatibility. So feedback is important. The way text blocks were developed is quite interesting. In 2019, a feature called Raw Strings was published as a preview feature in the JEP 326. This JEP was planned to be released in the JDK 12, but was in fact withdrawn. The reason was that a lot of user feedback showed several problems. In a nutshell, the implementation of this feature was just not ready. So your feedback matters. Check the preview features, go to the corresponding mailing list and provide feedback. Tell what you think. It is an excellent way to contribute to the JDK. And by the way, if you want to learn more on how to activate the preview features and use them, you can go to this page of the dev.java website. So, text blocks are a feature taken from the raw strings feature that didn't make it to the JDK. What is it about? In a nutshell, a text block is a new way to write strings of characters, spanning several lines of your Java program, and that avoids the need for most escape sequences. There are four goals for this JEP. First goal, to simplify the writing of strings that span several lines of source code while avoiding escape sequences in common cases. And I will show you examples of that in a minute. Second goal, to enhance the readability of strings that denote code written in non-Java languages. Think about SQL language or HTML or XML, these kind of things. Third goal, to be compatible with existing strings of character in your code. You can copy an existing string with its escape sequences and paste it in a text block and get the same results without having to modify anything. And fourth and last goal, add special escape sequences for managing explicit whitespace and new line control. As usual, this JEP also gives its non-goal, and it's always interesting to check them. There are also four of them. First, text blocks are instances of string, so no new class, no new type to model text blocks. Second, the plus operator on string is not redefined, and no new operator is created for text blocks. So S1 plus S2 is still the concatenation of S1 and S2. Third, text blocks are not raw strings. So there is no way to prevent the content of a text block from being analyzed by the compiler. The fourth and last point is really important. Text blocks do not directly support what is called string interpolation. What is string interpolation? String interpolation is about adding references to external variables within a string of characters and seeing these references replaced with the value of these variables. It is mentioned in the JEP that string interpolation may be considered in a future JEP. So it is a feature that may appear in the future in the Java language. And if this is the case, be sure that the JEP Cafe will cover it. In the meantime, you can use the formatted method of the string class available from the JDK 15 that can create a formatted string from a format and some arguments, just as you do it with the printf method of the printwriter class that you use with the system.out object. How can you create a text block? Super easy. Just open a triple double quote and a line feed. This line feed is mandatory. If you omit it, you will get a compiler error. Then all the characters that follow are part of this text block, up to the next three double quotes that close the text block. So the following text block is just what you would expect, a piece of HTML code with its indentation. And the same goes for this SQL snippet. You can notice that you do not need to escape the double quotes in a text block, which is awesome. If you need it, you can still escape the special character, which makes your life easier if what you need is to copy existing strings with these escape sequences in a new text block. The first question that comes to mind is, what will happen if my IDE decides to indent my text blocks? For instance, something like that. That could even become something like that with even more indentation. In fact, in that case, the compiler will analyze and remove the spaces added by the indentation. Most of the time, these are spaces of tabulations, and they are called incidental white spaces in a JEP. The spaces that are found before the closing triple double quotes of the first element of the text blocks are incidental white spaces and removed from the text block. In this example, the characters on the left of the vertical bar are not part of the text block. Here, the text block is aligned on the closing triple double quotes. And on this other example, the text block is aligned on the select keyword. And the same goes in this case, where the closing triple double quotes is at the end of the line. Line feeds or carriage returns are translated to line feed characters or backslash n in text block. You can also specify that you do not want them, even if they are in a source code. For that, you just need to add a backslash at the end of the line. Be careful not to leave a white space after this backslash, because in that case, you will get a compiler error. On this example, all the line feeds have been escaped, so the resulting string is just this single line. Playing with the position of the closing triple double quotes allows you to control how many white spaces you want to preserve at the beginning of each line of your text. But if you don't do anything, the compiler will remove all the white spaces at the end of each line. Now, if you need to preserve them also, or at least to control them, you can add a backslash s at the end of each line. All the white spaces or tabulations between the last character of each line and this backslash s will be kept by the compiler. You can see that on the following example, where backslash s characters have been added at the end of each line. And now with the following code, you can see that the white spaces have been kept at the end of each line. This code streams all the lines of this string one by one and adds a pipe character at the beginning and at the end of each of these lines. It will display the following on your console. As usual, you can read the JEP 378, where you will find more examples on how line feeds, white spaces, and other special characters are processed and escaped by the compiler. And with this, I'm out of coffee. So that's it for today. Talk to you soon.